the ayat aside because mostly ayat is known to the many people, but the hadith is what we ignore most of the time. So inshallah we'll do arkan al-iman the same way. We'll bring every rukn some hadith. From 5 hadith to 10 hadith, alhamdulillah, inshallah, whatever we found. I'm looking for only short hadith that will be easy to memorize, easy to learn them. So in this hadith of Jibreel alayhi salam, they narrated even the manner, the way he came. Not only the questions he asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sahabi who narrated the hadith, one of these riwayat is for Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu. He mentioned how Jibreel came alayhi salam, that a man wearing shadidul biyadu thiyab, very white clothes, shadidu sawadi sha'r, and he got very dark hair, la yura alayhi athar of safar, and he has no sign of travel. He does not look tired, he doesn't have dust on him. You see, the way they describe, we learn from there, this is the adab, this is the manner we should took when we are going to learn ilm. We should be in the best manner. We should dress nicely. And we shall come to the place of learning with adab. And I think our days they call we dress smartly. Your dress won't change your khilqat, your fitra. So the way Jibreel came, he was showing us the adab, the etiquette that's needed from a talib al-ilm. How a talib al-ilm should behave, and in which manner he should face that opportunity of learning ilm, learning deen. And also the way he came and he sat in front of Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You see, the sahaba, they left nothing out. They reported to us everything. He came وَأَسْنَدَ رُكْبَتَيْهِ إِلَى رُكْبَتَيْهِ. He placed his knees against the knees of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came so close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he put his hand عَلَى فَخْذَيْهِ, on his thighs. This shows how a talib should be eager to learn. You should have that urge of ilm, that you are coming so close to the alim. You don't want to miss anything. Then from there, he started questioning him. Also, we learn from this hadith, this is one way of learning, by asking questions. And the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is also guiding us the same way. فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Go and ask those who know if you don't know. Yeah? You don't know? So you go and ask those who know. By questioning them, by asking them, you're learning. That's one form of getting knowledge. Then, after that, the question starts. He started from the most important one, Al-Islam. What is Al-Islam? And Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't give him long definition. He make it very short. That means Islam is amal. A'mal is needed. Actions. After you give your declaration and testimony that Allah alone is to be worshipped, then you follow it with that actions. You worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stands for, you cannot worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without teaching and methods shown by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no amal that you will call, an action that you will call an act of worship, unless it is from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So there is no way of just picking any amal and saying this is also khair, this is also good, I will worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like, no. You want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you follow Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then from there, iqamatu salah. And you will find in nasus of this deen, whenever salah is mentioned, even the Quran, ayat of the Quran, the word iqama is mentioned. Aqimu salah, establish salah. Iqama, qama, qiyam, all this is the same words of Arabic. It's taken. When someone is standing, what is he doing? He's establishing himself upright. That means you should be upright with your salah. Establish salah. And this is what ulama says, we have to learn salah from the beginning. We learn the preconditions of salah, shurutu salah. Then you come, you learn arkanu salah. Then you add whatever sunan and hayat, you add from salah. You learn all these things, then you can establish your salah. But without learning all this, then you cannot establish salah. It's like someone whom you ask him to build for you a building, but he never built before, he doesn't know what to do. Will that building be strong? He will just put bricks on each other and they can fail anytime. So if you want to build your salah, you establish your salah, you learn. Most of the time, we don't know all the shurut, the preconditions of salah. So we have to go and learn shurutu salah. There is no madhab in all those four madhabs, a madhab which is not mentioning shurutu salah. Every madhab will tell you, this is shurutu salah. They may have slight difference of some shurut, but they all mentioning shurutu salah. Where this ulama came from with this shurut, where they bring it from? They bring it from the nusus, the text of the wahi, of the Quran and the sunnah. That's where they get. Sometimes you are okay with your shurut, 100%, alhamdulillah. But you are poor in your arkan. You don't know arkan salat. Yeah, you can't bring arkan salat as the way they are. We say your salat is nothing. Without arkan salat, your salat. Arkan, the pillars of salat, then your salat is nothing. The same way, if shurut are missing, one shart is missing, your salah is also nothing. There's no salah there. One rukn is missing, there's no salah there. So if you bring all the shurut, but the arkan are missing, still your salah is nothing. That means you cannot leave shurut aside, you cannot leave arkan aside. You have to bring both of them. Then the other things follow, wajibat and sunan. All this we learn from hadith of Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Step by step, that's where the ulama, they take this arkan. So that when you are shurut and arkan and wajibat and sunan in your salah are perfect, then you establish the salah. There's a strong salah. That's when maybe your salah will reflect and it will stop you from doing haram. Inna salata tanha an al-fahshai wal-munkar. Is the salah that's established well according to the teaching of Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ask any Muslim who taught you salah. He will tell you your parents. Do your parents know God, ilm of deen? No. So they taught you the way they think it is. So it is up to you now to go and find out, look for a hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that's teaching a salah and compare your salah to this hadith. If there's anything which is wrong, then you correct. If you don't understand, you go back to فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Go and ask those who know you, ask them, they will correct you. That's how we learn. Establish salah, ita'u zakah. Then, sawmu ramadan. All this need knowledge, ilm. بَابُ الْعِلْمِ قَبْلَ الْقَوْلِ وَالْعَمَلِ. We always follow ilm before words and actions. So inshallah, this hadith I will bring, they will concern arkanul iman. We have finished with arkanul Islam. Afterwards, maybe we'll start again. Go back with the same hadith. We repeat again and again. But we inshallah finish with arkanul iman. They are also very important. That's why Jibril alayhi salam, his second question was about iman. Akhbirni anil iman. You see the way he's asking, like a talib. Someone who wants to learn. Jibril knows alayhi salam already. But the end of the hadith, what Nabiullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell us, yu'allimukum. It's we who are learning. See, Jibril was just acting as a talib, talib al-ilm, as a student of knowledge. He was learning. That's how we should be. We follow that sunnah brought by Jibril alayhi salam to Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And every time he's asking him, he never came and said, what is Islam? See, what is Islam? No, he's asking in a good manner, akhbirni, tell me. That means I don't know. You tell me about Islam. Akhbirni an al-Iman. Tell me about Iman. Akhbirni an Ihsan. Then he asked him about Alamat al-Qiyamah. He asked about the time when will be Qiyamah. You see, also there we learn still the adab of learning ilm. If you don't know anything and you've been asked, you say, I don't know. Allahu A'lam. That's why Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell Jibreel, mal mas'oolu anha a'lam min as-sa'il. The one you're asking doesn't know from the one who is asking. You don't know, also I don't know. Both of us, we don't know. If something is not known by Nabi Muhammad and not known by Jibreel, who knows? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he means Allahu A'lam. Only Allah knows. Oh, if that's the case, they tell me alamat, some signs. Yeah, some signs of Qiyam. And Nabi Muhammad mentioned some few signs of the Qiyam. So you are being given a small one discussion, but a large training. How you should learn ilmuddin, which adab you need, how you should ask questions. And from that hadith, you can start establish your knowledge. You're starting from there. That's why some mu'allimin of the madrasa, first thing they teach is that hadith. Then the second hadith they teach is innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat. And some they start with innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat, then they follow it with this hadith. And the third hadith they follow is man ta'allama al-Qur'an wa 'allamahu khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'an wa 'allamahu. They follow that hadith. Now that means all this knowledge will found them in the Quran. Man ta'allama al-Quran. Go and learn the Quran. So you start from there. Inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of understanding. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us chances of learning. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the biggest of all, which is understanding what we are learning. Sometimes we collect knowledge, but we don't understand. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told about Yahud in the Quran. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ حُمُّلِ التَّوْرَاتِ. See, they were loaded with Taurat, full of knowledge. But they became كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلِ الْأَسْفَارَ. They became just like donkeys loaded with books, volumes of books. There's no one book that donkey will take and read. Learn from nothing, only wait. So if we got all these books and we just read them, just the way we read newspapers, and we don't understand, or we don't bother to understand, then we'll become, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ الْحِمَارِ يَحْمِلُ أَسْفَارَ. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq of learning, understanding, and applying. Yeah? We go back to the usulu thalatha. You learn, you apply, and you invite others. You spread what you learn. جزاكم الله خير وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.
So my friend, I'll tell you the second. Yeah, so where they stop.